A very good morning to all of you. This is Abhilashan Hata, your social science teacher, and today we are going to continue our chapter 1 of your political science book. And in our last class we discussed two of the features of democracy, and today we are going to continue with the features. And your next feature is one person, one vote, one value. So earlier we read about how the struggle for democracy was linked to the demand for universal adult franchise. Now anybody is interested in letting me know what is the meaning of universal adult franchise? It means every adult citizen have the right to vote without any discrimination, without any kind of discrimination. Okay, and this principle has now come to be accepted almost all over the world, and yet there are many instances of denial of equal rights to vote. So until 2015, in Saudi Arabia, women did not have the right to vote. But now in Saudi Arabia also women have the right to vote. Estonia has made its citizenship rulers in such a way that people belonging to Russian minority find it difficult to get the right to vote. Okay, Estonia, in Estonia, citizenship rules, what the citizenship rules are saying, they're saying that people belonging to Russian minority should not have a right to vote, but now they made it compulsory to have the right to vote for Russian minorities also. In Fiji, the electoral system is such that the vote of an indigenous Fiji has more value than that of an Indian Fijian. Okay, in Fiji, what the electoral system says, there that Fiji, who is the native Fiji or who is the native person here, carries more value of vote than the Indian Fiji or the or you can say the non-native Fiji. So importance, or you can say ki jo value hai yahan pe Fiji ki zyada value hai vote ki, aur Indian Fiji ya fir non-native Fijian ki value kam hai, voting value kam hai. So democracy is based on a fundamental principle of political equality that gives us the third feature of a democracy, that is, in a democracy each adult citizen must have one vote and each vote must have one value. Okay, each citizen, कोई भी citizen हो, अगर हम India की बात करते हैं तो India की कोई भी citizen हो, either woman, man, scheduled caste का हो या scheduled tribe का हो, ठीक है, upper class का है, lower class का है, कोई भी citizen है, every adult citizen must have one vote and each vote carries equal value. Each vote must have one value. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि हिंदूज हैं तो हिंदूज की वोट की वैल्यू ज़्यादा है और दूसरे रिलीजन या दूसरे क्रिश्चियंस की वैल्यू कम है, ऐसा नहीं होगा. हर कोई भी एडल्ट सिटीजन 18 ईयर्स का है इन इंडिया, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इंडिया, 18 ईयर्स का है तो above 18 every citizen must have one vote and each vote must have one value. Okay, we will discuss more about in our further chapters also. Now so we will discuss these cartoons later on. Okay, now your next topic, next feature is rule of law and respect for rights. Zimbabwe attained independence from white minority rule in the year 1980. Since then the country has been ruled by ZANU-PF, the party led the freedom struggle. Its leader Robert Mugabe ruled the country since independence. Elections were held regularly and always won by ZANU-PF. President Mugabe was popular but also used unfair practices in elections. Over the years, his government changed the constitution several times to increase the powers of the president and make him less accountable. Opposition party workers were harassed and their meeting disrupted. Public protest and demonstrations against the government were declared illegal. There was a law that limited the right to criticize the president. Television and radio were controlled by the government and gave only the ruling party's version. There were independent newspapers, but the government harassed those journalists who went against it. The government ignored some court judgments that went against it and pressurized judges. He was forced out of office in the year 2017. Now just look at this example. In Zimbabwe mein jab independence ka button ki thi in the year 1980, kisse white minority, most of the countries jo hai colonized thi, Zimbabwe bhi usme se ek country hai, white minorities aur aap keh sakte ho whites jo hai in pe रूल कर रहे थे, बट फाइनली 1980 में जिम्बाब्वे ने क्या की थी, इंडिपेंडेंस गेन कर ली थी, अटेन कर ली थी, एंड उसके बाद जिम्बाब्वे जब इंडिपेंडेंट जिम्बाब्वे इंडिपेंडेंट हुए, उसके बाद से एक ही ये जो कंट्री है जिम्बाब्वे, जानू पीएफ एक पार्टी का नाम है जिम्बाब्वे में, कि द पार्टी दैट लेड द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल, ठीक है, जिसने फ्रीडम के लिए स्ट्रगल किया था, या फ्रीडम के लिए, या आप बोल सकते हो जितने भी नेशनलिस्ट लीडर्स थे इसी पार्टी से बिलोंग करते थे, यही पार्टी क्या कर रही थी, लेड कर रही थी. इसके इनके लीडर्स कौन थे, द लीडर वॉज इट्स लीडर रॉबर्ट मुगाबे. Ruled the country since independence, and elections were held for the sake of the name. Elections were held regularly, but it was won only by ZANU PF party. Okay, time by time, what is happening here? President Mugabe was popular. He became popular and used unfair practices in election. Just like in Mexican example, also we have seen that PRI used unfair practices to won the elections. Just like that, President Mugabe of Zimbabwe, or you can say ZANU PF party, used unfair practices in elections. Over the years, he changed constitution, gave more powers to the president, and make the situations critical for opposition parties, harassed them, and public protest held by the opposition parties were disrupted by them. और पब्लिक प्रोटेस्ट को उन्होंने इलीगल डिक्लेयर कर दिया था. टेलीविज़न एंड रेडियो में भी जो कंट्रोल था, जो मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्रोल वाज विद गवर्नमेंट ओनली, जो वो दिखाना चाहते थे, रूलिंग पार्टी का जो वर्जन दिखाना चाहते थे मीडिया के थ्रू भी, वो टेलीविज़न और रेडियो को उन्होंने अपने अंदर कंट्रोल रख लिया था, और जो दिखाना चाहते थे उनका वर्जन, रूलिंग पार्टी का वर्जन, वो ही दिखा रहे थे. न्यूज़पेपर्स थे, बट गवर्नमेंट उन्हें भी क्या कर रही थी, हैरेस कर रही थी, जर्नलिस्ट को हैरेस कर रही थी, जो भी उनके अगेंस्ट में जाते थे उनको वो हैरेस कर रही थी. बट ही वॉज फोर्स्ड आउट ऑफ ऑफिस इन द ईयर 2017. फाइनली 2017 में उनको क्या है, ये जो प्रेसिडेंटशिप थी उन्होंने लीव कर दी, या फिर फोर्सफुली उनको लीव करने के लिए बोला गया. सो दिस वॉज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ जिम्बाब्वे. Shows that popular approval of the ruler is necessary in democracy, but it is not sufficient. Popular governments can be undemocratic. Popular leaders can be autocratic. If we wish to assess a democracy, it is important to look at the elections, but it is equally important to look before and after the elections. There should be sufficient room for normal political activity, including political oppositions, in the period before elections. This requires that the state should respect some basic rights of the citizens. They should be free to think, to have opinions, to express these in public, to form associations, to protest and take other political actions. Everyone should be equal in the eyes of law. These rights must be protected by an independent judiciary whose orders are obeyed by everyone, and we will talk about judiciary later on. Okay, so in this example of Zimbabwe, we have seen public or normal citizens, or you can say opponent parties, have had no right to express their views. Journalists had no right to express their views. If they express their views, they were criticized, they were harassed for it. So in a democracy, it is important that everybody have a right to express their viewpoints. They should be free to think. They should respect their everyone should respect the citizens. Basic rights should be there for the citizens. They have the right to express their thinking in public. They have the right to make associations. They have right to protest, and etc. ye sari cheeze ek democracy mein aati hai. If we look at the example of India, we see in our daily lives and we see in the news also, newspapers, television channels, oh, everybody have the right to protest. Everybody have the right to express their viewpoints. Okay, government illegally नहीं बोल सकती कि आप जो हम दिखाना चाहते हैं आप वो ही दिखाइए. No, in India we have seen televisions, media, citizens have the right to protest, have the right to express their opinions at public, etc. So they have to think freely. They have the right to think freely. So etc. In a democracy, ये सारी चीजें जो है normal citizens को दी जाती है. Okay? So similarly, there are some conditions that apply to the way government is run after the elections. A democratic government cannot do whatever it likes. Yes. One more point. ज़रूरी नहीं है एक डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट बहुत पॉपुलर हो, बट वो डेमोक्रेटिक जो गवर्नमेंट है वो जो करना चाहेगा वो करेगा. ऑटोक्रेटिक रूल करेगा, मोनोपोली अपना करेगा, नहीं, ये राइट उसके पास नहीं है. ठीक है, जस्ट बिकॉज ही वॉन एन इलेक्शन और वो बहुत पॉपुलर है तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि वो अपना ऑटोक्रेटिक रूल करेगा, वो जैसा चाहेगा वैसा रूल करेगा. नो, इट हैज़ टू रिस्पेक्ट सम बेसिक रूल्स. इन पर्टिकुलर इट हैज़ टू रिस्पेक्ट सम गारंटीज टू द माइनॉरिटीज. माइनॉरिटीज़ को भी गारंटी देना पड़ेगा, उसे कंसल्टेशन, ऑपोजिशन पार्टीज के साथ भी कंसल्टेशन करनी पड़ेगी. Every office bearer has certain rights and responsibilities assigned by the constitution and the law. Each of these is accountable not only to the people but also to other independent officials. Jo independent officials hai unko bhi kya hai उनको भी क्या है, जितनी भी रूल्स हैं, जितनी भी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ हैं उन लोगों के लिए भी लागू होती है, और वो लोग को भी क्या है, अपनी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ निभानी चाहिए. ठीक है, सो आवर फोर्थ फीचर इज़ अ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट रूल्स विद इन लिमिट्स सेट्स बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लॉ एंड सिटीजन्स राइट्स. व्हाटएवर राइट्स, व्हाटएवर रूल्स, लिमिट्स गिवन इन योर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सेट बाय योर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लॉ, सिटीजन्स राइट्स, you should follow all these rules, and a government should rule according to that constitutional laws and citizens rights. Okay, aisa nahi hai aap election jeet chuke ho, aap ruling party ban chuke ho aur ab aap jo chahoge wo karoge. No, you can do all these things. आप जब चाहोगे आप constitution amend कर दोगे, नहीं, ऐसा नहीं होगा. You have to do the consultation with the opposition parties also. Okay? So if we sum up all the features of democracy, a democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. This is the definition we are studying from the beginning of this chapter. right? So we found that rulers elected by the people take all the major decisions. Jitne bhi major decisions hai, kaun le rahe hain? Rulers le rahe hain. So it is the responsibility of the rulers or elected representative that ki wo achhe decisions le. Elections offer a choice and fair opportunity to the people to change the current rulers. Elections jo hai, fair अपॉर्चुनिटीज इलेक्शंस के थ्रू फेयर अपॉर्चुनिटीज प्रोवाइड होनी चाहिए. आप इंडिया के इलेक्शंस को देखते हो, व्हाट यू हैव सीन कि एक मेजर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी है, क्या वो लॉन्ग टाइम तक हमेशा आप एक ही मेजर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी को देख रहे हो? नो. हम देखते हैं इंडिया में अभी जो टेन्योर चल रहा है, बीजेपी का चल रहा है, इससे पहले का टेन्योर भी बीजेपी का था, बट इससे पहले के दो टेन्योर्स किसके थे? इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस के थे. तो इन इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री एक इलेक्शंस क्या प्रोवाइड करवाती है? फेयर अपॉर्चुनिटीज, इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटीज प्रोवाइड करवाती है. जो पीपल है उनको चॉइस देती है, और उस चॉइस में जो पार्टीज होती है उनको फेयर चांस होता है लूज का भी, लूज करने का भी और विन होने का भी. ओके, so this choice and opportunity is available to all the people on an equal basis. All the choices given to the citizen should be on the equal basis. aisa nahi hoga ki scheduled caste ko humne kuch choices nahi diye, but humne general category ya fir aap obcs ko humne kuch category ya kuch opportunities de diye. no, equal opportunities aapko provide karwani hai har ek class ko, har ek कास्ट को, हर एक जेंडर को. ठीक है, हमें डिस्क्रिमिनेट नहीं करना है. वी शुड नॉट डिस्क्रिमिनेट पीपल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर कास्ट, क्रीड, सेक्स, जेंडर एटसेट्रा. वी शुड गिव इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू ऑल द पीपल ऑन एन इक्वल बेसिस, राइट? एंड द वेरी फोर्थ फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इज द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चॉइस लीड्स टू अ गवर्नमेंट limited by basic rules of the constitution and citizens' right. Okay, so this choice given to the government, or you can say this choice given to the government or given to the citizen, limited by basic rules. Everyone should follow some rules and regulations set by our constitutions. Okay, ऐसा नहीं है कि जो मन में आएगा करेंगे. हम तो लीडर बन चुके हैं, हम अपना कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अब अमेंड करेंगे. नो, द चॉइस लीड्स टू अ गवर्नमेंट लिमिटेड बाय बेसिक रूल्स ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड सिटीजन्स राइट. ओके, सो दीज आर द फोर बेसिक फीचर्स, और यू कैन से फंडामेंटल फीचर्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. ओके, नाउ जस्ट लुक एट द कार्टून्स. Just look at this cartoon given on page number 7. At last, one man, one vote. I liked it better when I was the one man and the one vote. Okay, so this cartoon is about the Iraqi elections held after Saddam Hussein's regime was overthrown. He is shown behind the bars. What is the cartoonist saying here? Compare the message of this cartoon with the first cartoon in this chapter. ठीक है, अब देखते हैं हम पहला कार्टून क्या है. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट लुक एट दिस कार्टून, वोट हेयर. सदम हुसैन, कोई बताएगा मुझे सदम हुसैन कौन थे? सदम हुसैन, एनीबडी?